Learn how to accelerate query performance while reducing your query compile time, all in SQL Server 2022 with no code changes. This week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, we're going to be talking about some new performance features that can help your queries run faster with no code changes. And for this, I'm going to bring on Derek. He's a PM on the SQL team. Derek, thanks so much for joining me.
Absolutely. Thank you for having me. It's wonderful to be here.
Yeah, it's great to have you on Data Exposed. Today, we're going to be talking about the intelligent query processing features and one capability in specific, and that's optimized plan forcing. Now, I have no idea what this is, so I'd love to just kick it off and learn more about it.
Yep, absolutely. Yeah, so what is optimized plan forcing? You kind of stole my thunder there, because my very first introduction is the question that I was hoping you would ask me, Anna. Essentially, what optimized plan forcing is, it's a way for us to improve the query optimization process to make things faster, right? There could be certain scenarios where a query compiles, it takes a long time, uses a bunch of resources. This feature helps with all of that. One thing that we do is we will essentially start recording while optimization is occurring on a query, and we save that recording for all intents and purposes inside of what's known as the show plan XML, or the plan itself. So the next time the query executes, we don't have to do any recompilation steps if the plan's not in cache. We'll just read what we've already recorded. So really, the problem space here is really trying to address compilation problems. So you can find compilation problems in scenarios where, let's say, your database failed over, or you've had memory pressure and plans got kicked out of cache. If those types of things happen, having this feature on can save on compilation resources, like I had mentioned earlier. So just really quickly, before I show you how this works, because I seem to be talking a lot, the optimized plan forcing or optimization replay, as we sometimes call it, really has two phases. As I mentioned before, it has the capture phase, where we capture all the important optimization rules. So things like, you know, what type of join should we do? Should we do a semi-join? If there's a union all in the query, we check to see are the columns correlated with one another. All of those things that typically go on optimization in the optimization process get saved, so we don't have to repeat that process. The second phase of optimization replay is the replay, obviously. We will replay those steps instead of going through the entire process all over again. So I think I've been talking long enough here, Anna. Let's kind of show it.
Yeah, I'd love to see it in action.
All right. So what I have here is the infamous VentureWorks database. I did take the leisure of kind of making a couple of tables bigger, the sales order detail table and the sales order header table, just for dramatic effect. So just really quickly, I'm going to run a relatively simple query here. I'm going to also capture the statistics time so we can see how fast it actually ran. So let's save this information off. Let's save it for later. And what I'll do in this second window is I'll look inside of Query Store. And in particular, I'm just going to focus on that one query that I ran so we don't see everything else that's going on. So in this single query that just ran, we get the average compile time. Average and last would be the same because we just ran one query. And one thing that you'll notice is we also see that SQL Server thought that this query was interesting enough to create a compile replay script. You'll have some other metrics like the show plan, as I mentioned before. One thing that I didn't mention about the show plan is the data that we save inside of the show plan is actually hidden. So if you go poking around in the XML itself, you will not see the replay script itself. All right, so we'll leave these results up here. One other column that I did not focus on is for this feature to actually work, we did capture, but for the replay to work, the plan must be forced. So right now this plan is not forced, and I'm going to manually force this as opposed to going through the UI in Query Store, the Query Store UI. I'll just use the plan forcing store procedure. That store procedure takes two parameters, technically three. It will take the query ID and the plan ID of what you would like to force. It will also take a parameter known as the replica group ID, which really briefly, all that means is if you have an availability group set up or secondary servers, you can force plans directly on those particular instances.
Makes sense.
Okay, so we just forced that plan, and if I run this same query again just to refresh things, we can now see nothing's changed because I didn't re-execute the query, but now the plan is forced. So to make things slightly interesting, I do not ever recommend doing this on a production server, but I'm going to clear the procedure cache just for demo purposes. So now we have a cold cache. If I run the same query again and then turn my time off, you can see the data. It ran a little bit faster. Slightly faster.
Yeah.
But what's important to note is if I were to take a look at Query Store, you will see that it previously ran, the average compile time was about 876 milliseconds. It went to about half of that. The duration was 876 milliseconds. Wow. And now we're down to 12 milliseconds. So dramatic improvement. Just by forcing the plan and using the optimization replay script.
That's huge.
Absolutely. One thing that I sometimes hear from folks is this is great, but sometimes I don't always force my plans. I don't know when to force plans. How can I take advantage of this feature? I know, Anna, you're probably going to ask me that question. But so in SQL Server 2017, we introduced a feature known as automatic tuning. That option is not on by default in SQL Server 2022. However, you can turn that feature on just within the database scope. So in this particular case, I'll take the comments off so we can see the nice pretty colors here. I'm going to force automatic tuning to be on, and it takes one option in SQL Server 2022 and SQL Server 2017 and later, known as force last good plan. Why this is important to think about, especially in SQL Server 2022, is we had introduced a new plan regression model that really looks at, it does a much better job than the previous model in detecting regressions and plan performance, enforcing those the last good plan, right? So one caveat to using the new model in SQL Server 2022, and this is all documented on our in our trace flags notes as well as the notes for cumulative update 4 for SQL Server 2022. Is to use the new model, you have to turn on a trace flag. This trace flag is called, it goes by the number 12618. This will allow the automatic plan correction feature to use the brand new model with new and improved heuristics. There's also a second trace flag that's very useful for cases where you had, let's say, for example, someone had a bunch of queries that we're looking for, how many data exposed videos were hosted or executed by Anna Hoffman, right? So as you can imagine, let's say there were a million of those things. If someone also said, well, I also want to see how many data exposed videos included Bob Ward, right? There might only be like one or two, because Bob's not a very popular guy. So if someone were to execute the Bob Ward query once, the plan cache got cleared, they looked for Anna Hoffman, that Anna Hoffman query would essentially end up with, to say, a table scan, right? It might be a million rows that come back. If they go back and search for Bob Ward, because there's only a few Bob Ward statements, we might end up doing a table scan when we don't have to. The automatic plan correction would detect that regression and force a plan back to one that's more suitable for Bob Ward, right? Once that kicks in, that particular query, if it were qualified for the optimization replay, would compile a lot quicker and run faster the next time someone executes.
Makes sense. Derek, this has been super useful. I've learned a lot. Actually, even I learned about things that I didn't know you were going to talk about necessarily. So I've learned a lot. I think our viewers have learned a lot. I think I just want to make sure I'm clear. Like, if I want to take advantage of this new capability, I need to turn on automatic tuning for the forest last good plan. And I need to enable those two trace lags. Are there any reasons why, like, are there any cautions, like, before you turn this on? Or, like, do we pretty much recommend everyone should go turn this on and their queries are going to run faster?
So for the actual feature, the optimization replay, that you get for free just by installing SQL Server 2022. Gotcha. It will not record. It will record things, but it will not replay anything until you force a query plan. Right. So if you're not sure which query plans you need to manually force, then you can turn on the automatic tuning option and let the system automatically figure out where plans have regressed. It will force those plans on your behalf, and then this new feature will kick in.
Got
I know it. It's kind of a lot.
No, I just want to make sure we all understand, we all know what to do and how to take advantage of this. You know, Derek, thanks so much again for coming on the show, teaching us a lot of about optimized plan forcing and some of the other things related to it. To our viewers, if you like this episode, go ahead and give it a like. Leave us a comment and let us know any impact you're seeing when you add this to your SQL Server workloads. And we'll put some links in the description for you to learn more. We hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.